Alrighty, guys. Yeah, so we're halfway there right now. All right, guys. Well, I will find this graffiti. This graffiti will not beat me in any way possible. Any shape, any way, shape, or form. Oh no. Don't tell me it's where I think it is. Never mind, guys. I found it. I found it. I found it. And I was right next to it too, and I didn't even notice. I was right next to it, you guys, and I did not even notice that. That is so strange how I did not see that. Okay, guys. So, I feel like I'm the one being dumb about this. That's just my opinion, but I doubt that I am. I mean, I already know that I'm not dumb, but it's just, it was really hard for me to find the chickens. Okay, so there's that. Now I'm swimming. I'm literally swimming right now in the water. And they said in the video right now that there is a rock. Jeez, it would be better if I got to take a boat or something. There's gonna be another rock that has not been labeled. Which I think is over there. But it's on one of the rocks and stuff, and I need to make sure. Okay.
Ugh.
I think it's over here, you guys. I don't know exactly. I think it's way over here, but I don't know. If it is, then that's good, but if not, I'm gonna be upset. Not li well, I'm not gonna be upset, I'm just gonna be confused. Wait.
Our next little stretch of water, as you see, is only a moat. For the area, you're looking for from the right on top of the rock in the middle of the ocean is another unknown strange rock.
Let's hope I find this rock, you guys. Oh, I think it's that one over there, I think. There it is. All right, guys, I found it.
Little strange rock, as you see, is already on the boat. For the area, you're looking for from train track safe house that we came from that way. So now you have to swim back to shore, though. Next little strange rock, as you see, is already on the boat. For the area, you're looking for from the train track safe house, pretty much straight down, you're looking for.
Okay, guys. I need to look for the train track safe house.
This tiny little area you're looking for from the train track safe house, pretty much straight down. You're looking for this tiny little like fishing village, basically. Two boats and
Okay, guys. Oh no. I'm in some deep shit. Literally, guys, I'm in some deep trouble right now. Okay, there we go. That was a demolisher. I'm not fighting the demolisher along with other undeads. So, I'm gonna pass on that. Thank you. Alrighty, let's do this. Alrighty, you guys. We are halfway there right now. We're really close. Once I get all the stones, I'm gonna show you guys the most interesting thing ever. Uh-oh. Well. Looks like I'm swimming. Or I could just replace my vehicle, like put it back up again so that. Sorry, guys. I was just looking at something. There it is. So, there we go. All right, guys, give me just a second. I need to find it.
Next rock you're looking for. You don't have to swim to it either.
I'm sorry, guys.
For
I'm just
our
trying to.
next rock, you're looking.
Okay, so it's by the volatile nest. Oh, it's this one right here. It's that way.
I think there's actually like a safe house or a later mission for it that gives you that as a safe house or something, but I'm not in that section of the storyline yet. So the thing of it is getting This rock is a little bit more hidden than the rest of them, but it is right there. We have
Okay, guys.
Another strange rock, and now you have to climb back up again.
So let's sleep. Okay. So first things first, you guys, we're gonna sleep. Because this one's a little tricky to find. Because if we sleep, the stone will glow. And it'll be like the most prettiest thing you guys are gonna that you guys are going to see from this. So I'm gonna show you guys what this stone looks like in the night.
I think there's actually like a safe house.
7 hours later.
Or that gives you that as a safe house or something, but I'm not in that section of the storyline yet. So the thing of it is getting down there without dying can be a little bit tricky. Again, for all this, you might want to have some med kits, or you could try and do it at night because this rock is a little bit more hidden than the rest of them, but it is right there. So we have yet another strange rock, and now you have to climb back up again. But the next rock, you're looking for this sawmill that we drove through. And specifically, basically.
Hold on, guys. I'm trying to figure out. Okay, so I need to find the ones that's got a lot of, like. All right, guys, hold on. Give me a sec. I'm trying to understand where this is at. Oh, I think it's above me.
Again, for all this, you might want to have
I think it's above me.
Or you could try and do it at night cuz this rock is a little
All right. This is what it looks like, you guys.
Right there.
This is what the stone looks like. It's so pretty. I like it. Let me know down in the comments. Let me know down in the comments. And let me know if it's really pretty or not. I think it's really pretty. It's really pretty. I like it. So, there you go, you guys. We're really close. Really close to getting this done. So, I'm really excited to get this done and over with. And all that fun stuff. So, I cannot wait to get this finished. And I'll show you guys the reward too. Actually, I'll show you guys definitely the reward.
Strange rock, and now you have to climb back up again. next rock, you're looking for this sawmill that we drove through, and specifically, basically the end of this rail car that I'm sitting on. So once you clear out the zombies, you can usually have to.
All right, guys, give me
But the
just a
next rock,
second.
you're looking for this sawmill that we drove through.
Okay. Okay, so it's by the train tracks. Okay, so here is the sawmill, you guys.
Specifically, basically
So we are really close, you guys, to the goal.
welcome back
We
to
are
Fallen Angel
really,
Pacific
really
Simulator.
close.
We are back on Dying Light in the following DLC on the Xbox One, of course joined by Slowpoker, and today I have a guide for you on all of the unknown strange rock locations, which this is for the, I guess you would call it, the UFO Easter egg. So, rock number one is going to be all the way up here, kind of at the north portion of the map. You're looking for this little building where the ritual that you have to go to for the gathering quest is. So, you all can get to this part
Now I
pretty
could
easily. You get to
refuel.
the rock location from here. It's relatively easy to do, but you might want to have a couple med kits on hand just in case, because you have to come way down
No,
here and you will
despair.
actually take a considerable amount of
Ow,
fall
ow,
damage.
ow. I thought you guys were good
Yes.
guys. You guys are jerks. Why would you do this to me?
A goddamn biter!
Keep your rotting hands off me!
So, this video will
So yeah,
take
guys,
place
I'm
in
just
the
going
old locations
back
of this map,
through the original
you are now
videos and
down
stuff,
here at the
so
second rock location. Alright, so rock number two, you're gonna be looking for this little compound right here, and it's gonna be just off of the main road here down in the riverbed. This one I'm going to go ahead and show you at night, simply because the rock glows, so you have an idea for what you're looking for. Literally, right here, it's a glowing rock. That's number two. Killed a few things attacking us, and we'll head for number three. Alright, for the third rock, you will be coming to this train. Really train tracks with tunnel locations, and normally there's a volatile mass there, except I already cleared it out. So right there on the map is where you're looking for it, and we'll be running all the way to the back of it. So I will be using a Night Hunter booster so it doesn't take as long. If you have some of those, you might want to use them. But we quite literally have to run all the way to the back of what would be this volatile nest. Right there. Number three, strange rock amongst a million bodies. So grab that if you haven't killed all the
Oh
volatiles and get
shit!
the hell out as fast as possible.
Die, you undead
Alright, now
freak!
that I had to take care of a few virals, rock number four. What used to be
Yes!
the rock that you glitched out.
Shit.
Way up here.
This fucker doesn't want any
Oh, you
more
like
nukes.
this?
Should be on
God
the
damn
other
it.
side of the
Oh,
map
Peter!
that you couldn't get to.
Now
Now,
I got
luckily,
you.
God damn it!
God.
Alright, this is starting to annoy the hell out of me.
And right there, for the eye, there's a strange rock. So, an odd place. But,
we're gonna add this to the dark machete.
Another place for a rock.
Leave me alone, you creep!
From the previous one that was in the chicken's eye, you basically
go
all the way out.
Leave me alone!
Swim past all of these rocks and keep swimming to a rock that is not actually marked on the map, but it is this rock here. And right on top of the rock in the middle of the ocean is another unknown strange rock. And you can see the city that we came from.
Oh god. Oh god. Leave me alone.
Our next little strange rock, as you see, is already on the boat. But little, like, fishing thing. Start from this building. I'm not in that section. Right there. But the next rock, you're looking for this sawmill. Specifically, basically the end of this reservoir that I'm sitting on. So clear out the zombies. You can usually have to crouch down to get it, but it's right here on the ground.
Alright guys, give me just a second. I need to go around first, you guys. All right, let me pause this for a minute. Okay, guys, so there's another unknown strange rock that I picked up. So that is 11. Let's do this, guys.
Kind of like right in reference to where the wheel of the train car is. And off to our next rock. This basically hillside on the map. There's one little house and one hunt.
Okay, guys, so okay, guys. Oh, there it is. Alrighty, you guys, here we go. We're getting close.
Here, it's kind of hard to see unless you're at night, but there's your next strange rock. And off to the next one. For the next rock, you're looking for, well, pretty much everybody's familiar with, like, this little racetrack down here, but you're looking for this specific section of the racetrack, and if you come up on the hill, then you can kind of little racetrack down here, but you're looking for this.
So this little that certain spot right there.
Specific section of the racetrack, and if you come up on the hill, then you can kind of see, especially if you crouch down or you're at night, this strange rock right here. Right in the green area in between the flowers on the left and right sides. Now, yeah. Alright, for our next strange rock, you will be coming to the dam. And this one I'm doing at night because the water here is just.
Oh, Jenna!
There's your next strange rock. And off to the next one. For the next rock, you're looking for, well, pretty much everybody's familiar with, like, this little racetrack down here, but you're looking for this specific section of the racetrack. And if you come up on the hill, then you can kind of see, especially if you crouch down or you're at night, this strange rock. Right in the green area in between the flowers and off to the next one. For the next rock, you're looking for, well, pretty much everybody's familiar with, like, this little racetrack down here, but you're looking for this specific section of the racetrack.
Alrighty, guys. Well, this is part one, I guess. This is gonna end up, mainly a part one. Okay, now the next one is the dam.
Eventually, you'll make it out into roughly the middle of the lake here, or pond, river, whatever you want to call it, and then you'll have to dive for the rock. So, yeah, like 2 minutes of swimming and one rock. At least the volatiles don't bother you in this area, though.
Oh.
And I'll turn off my light so you can see the rock better, but there you go. One rock. At least the volatiles don't bother you in this area, though. No. turn off my light so you can see the rock better, but there you go. One rock. How dirty this water is, and with all the current, that's what we really need to do it at night so you can see the rock adequately. So, on to our next location. Now for the actual Easter egg.
Alright guys, I managed to find it in this dirty water.
The house that you need is this little house that we started at, right by the dam. And we'll be going up into the attic, which, you know what, it's kind of dark up there. Oh, another mattress.
Okay, guys, here we go. Now this is where the real fun's gonna begin. The real fun. It's gonna be the real fun thing. Hold on, guys.
How dirty the lake here, or pond. And I'll turn off my... And you can kind of see how dirty this water is. The house that you need is this little house that we started at. Right by the dam.
Oh, never mind, guys. I went the wrong location. Sorry, that's my fault. That one was on me.
And you're looking for this weird symbol. Now we can place down all these rocks.
Sorry guys, that was on me.
Just smash the X button for
empty lubricant.
Making a very interesting shape pattern doesn't really necessarily matter the order that you place these down in. Just making sure that you have all.
Okay, guys, here we go. One, two,
and then you can use that one.
Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. 15. Guys, I think I did something wrong. Hold on.
New gear?
Give me a sec, you guys. Hold on. I need to find my bed. Where's my bed? Where's my bed? This is not funny, dude. Where's my bed? I worked so hard on this Easter egg, And I'm wanting to do this.
Relatively easy to do, but you might want to have a few med kits on hand just in case you have to come way down to the ground. It'll actually take a considerable amount of fall damage when doing this.
Guys, it's not, oh wait, alright guys, ready, here we go. Oh, a UFO, let's go. Let's go guys, UFO. I want you guys to put in the comments hashtag UFO. That would be awesome. If you guys could subscribe to my channel as well, that would also help a lot. I worked so hard for this Easter egg right now, and so let's get this finished. Hold on, guys. I need to read something first. Hold on.
We quite literally have to run all the way to the back of what would be this volatile nest.
Electronics, power cable, metal parts, and batteries. Alright, guys. Well, that's the Easter egg. Alright guys, I need to get to the safe zone as quickly. Actually, let's check and see where the nearest one is, because I need the nearest safe house or the safe zone. Oh, that was close, you guys. That thing almost spotted me.
Actually out in the water. Used to be on the other side of the map that you couldn't get to. Now, finally, you can get to it. So, awesome on that fact. And believe me, we did try.
And then 15, I guess I have. I guess. By the time I get my stuff back, you guys, including my grappling hook as well,
at least they fixed that, and now you can complete the Easter egg.
This is gonna be amazing, so.
Alright, next rock you are looking for is in this.
Welcome, welcome!
Here,
please
Hey, what's going on, buddy?
That just sounds like fun.
Underwater algae.
How's my way?
Okay, guys, here we go.
There we go. At the bottom of the well.
Let's take all the stuff that I finally have now.
Getting out of the well, that's the more difficult part. So for some reason,
the dark machete I had, I will need the dark machete. I'm going to store that right in there.
In the actual game.
Excuse me. So that way. Oh man. I need my rusty spine.
Location is going to be kind of right in the middle of this field, not too far down from your safe zone off the main road. Of course, there's some spirals here because of the firecrackers. This one can be a little.
I need my grappling hook. So, yeah, guys.
Time to go for a swim. Inventory, though. In the player's stash. So, it's probably going to take me like 2 minutes just to open my freaking player's stash.
So, let's do this. Let's see what we can.
And I'm not worried with getting everything.
Let's see what we can do, guys. Alright, now where is it? There's the kids. I'm gonna take a. I'm gonna sleep through the night, so that way. And there we go, guys. 3 hours later. There you go, man. And then let's sell that. I really want the skull machete right now. Oh, I should probably grab some of the other stuff too, because all I have is.
I don't want to have every single thing in my inventory, though.
I need.
So, not everything that I wanted to have in my inventory, that's why I was picking and choosing certain things, but, you know, hey, whatever. We'll deal with that later.
I want the last wish, and then I also want Fenris. So, guys, I'm gonna show you guys some of this really cool stuff that I got for the last couple days. So, I'm just gonna show you guys. So this right here is Fenris. I like it because it's got the wolves symbol right there, and it's pretty good battle axe. Last wish. Also like this as well. It's pretty nice. And then there you go. And then I have my dark machete, which isn't too impressive. So. I need to buy all that. Tin can, chemicals, batteries, aerosol, gauze, wire, steel tubing, rubber, power, lubricants. Okay, nails, alcohol, screws, med kits. Shotgun ammo is very important. SMG, nope. So, I can craft some new items right now, you guys. So, let me start reloading this. Okay, there's that. Blueprints, let's see what we can do. I can make one of these, so I can only produce one. So that's not. That's not gonna do me any good. But, guys, ooh, that already gained 20 extra. Nice. So let's make one of these. I need to make a core. You know what, guys? I'll bring this just to be safe.
Alright, here we go at night.
Store all.
It's pretty expensive to craft ammo for this thing, but fun as hell. And you can just go running around the map with a giant glow stick, so put this weapon out.
Oh yeah, guys, so I'm gonna show you.
Run around with the glow in the dark paint job. Yeah, that would be amusing.
Hold on, guys. Let me get this reloaded first. Hold on. Alright, there we go. And then let me do last wish. So yeah, guys, that was the whole Easter egg. So I hope you guys enjoy. I hope you guys enjoyed the nice, beautiful Easter egg and all of that. So, all right. Well, that's going to be the end of the video, you guys. Thank you for watching and thank you for subscribing. So I'll see you guys in the next one.